Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. I visit Oxford quite every week, a couple of times or so, and meet these theologians. When I listen to them, that make no sense to me, because they just keep on saying things, whatever comes into their mouth. They will even say God's law. Now, everybody knows God is grace, and He does not make any law to bind you, or He to be bound by those laws. So our Father God is by grace. By grace He lives. He is all in all. So there's no one who can govern Him. So it is His grace that we seek, and then we prosper. So moral laws made in the light of Holy Spirit are sound, and they create peace and make the living as if you are living in heaven. That was it was stated in Matthew 13:52. The rabbis, which are the rulers, they are like the owner of a house, synagogue, who bringeth out from the storeroom treasures, old scriptures, which is written, and new gospel, or the oral Torah. When they are based upon this type of rabbi, who has the knowledge of both the scripture and the oral Torah, then these moral laws are sound and you have live in peace. The rabbi is no more a hypocrite. Whatever he say, he does it. That's why Christ Jesus said, don't do what rabbis do, but do what they tell you to do. Rabbis used to have the light of God, which is mercy. Now, to these university professors, if you ask them what is light and what is darkness, they have no idea, because there's nowhere in the book written the definition of light. So light is mercy, as the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person displayed. So in their hearts, and this Christ Jesus stressed, that the key to the kingdom of heaven was given to the rabbis. They themselves would not enter, that is, be merciful, and they would not let the others enter either. So they became cruel themselves, rulers, you know, and lacking mercy. So they were just imposing their views, orders, because they were, people obeyed them. They put a heavy yoke on the people. They put millstones around the necks of the people of ritual, which they themselves won't do. Sabbath is devoted to the worship of demiurge God Yahweh of nature. Now, Yahweh is the demiurge God of the nature. He is not real, mythological. He is the creator of male and female. And this is best celebrated by curing people of the physical ailments or disabilities. So, Sabbath, which is devoted to the demiurge God Yahweh, the creator of male and female, because it is concerned with the flesh. So any ailment concerning flesh should be cured on Sabbath, so that it is well celebrated. That's why Christ Jesus was doing. He was curing people of the physical diseases on Sabbath, the day devoted to God. That is what Christ Jesus was doing on Sabbath. But as the rabbis were merciless, objected to Christ Jesus performing the merciful deeds. So they objected Jesus performing, working on Sabbath. Well, Sabbath is a rest day from secular work, not from the spiritual. So you should devote the whole day to spiritual philanthropy. But they said, even don't make a cup of tea. It is a rest day. That is why they are spiritually dead. Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person demonstrated the light of God within him, whilst a rabbi and a Pharisee passed by. So that amply reflect how merciless or dry in God's light those people were. That was why the Jews, the disciple of such stone-hearted rabbis, were jealous of the Samaritans and hated them, as the Samaritan woman at the well stressed that you Jews hate us and you ask water of me. So they used to hate these Samaritans. Even today they hate them. And they want to go past the village of Samaritans, then they will not pass through the village but go around it, and then that in case, you know, they get any good thing coming out of the Samaritan be infiltrated into their character. Even today the Bible is so influenced by those Jews that they still hate the Samaritans. Samaritan, that woman, she and would not admit or know that the Samaritan woman at the well became an apostle called St.Photina. In all these Russian people, all those people in that belt, they know that she was St.Photina and how Nero murdered her. Here in Britain, they have no idea of St.Photina. And as I explained earlier, a Jewish man, professor from America, he wrote a book on John's Gospel, about 1,200 pages. And when I asked him, does he know St.Photina? No, he doesn't know anything. And when I asked about that character of this woman, oh, she was a bad woman, she was a sinner, and this and that. All nonsense they were talking. Sin carries no weight in Christ Jesus. So anybody who talks of sin in Christ Jesus, he is antichrist. In Jesus, it is the righteousness we count and hypocrisy we expose. As the Jews are hypocrite, that even this St.Photina, they don't want to know her. Similarly, all the 12 laborers of Christ Jesus at Pentecost on receiving the wage of Holy Spirit not only became the twin brethren of the anointed Christ Jesus, but they too became Christ, preaching gospel as Jesus had done. So they became Christ in all of them. Christ. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel. So I'm preaching gospel because I have Christ in my heart. So I'm not a Christian, but a Christ. So dead in spirit people, they are Christian. Book people, they are Christian. So you find them many. How many Christ you come across, you will be surprised. That is how the gospel was stated by Christ Thomas, who went to India. 1 in 1,000, 2 in 10,000 will understand gospel. So when I preach gospel, not many people take it. They just brushed it aside. Jewish people gave them the status of saint. So the Jewish people, you know, they gave them the status of the saint, and these people like Gregory and other saints, you know, they are proclaiming, they are nowhere knowing gospel. They were all antichrist because they were soft spoken, as most of them these are, so they are called saint. So that doesn't make you a knowing of a gospel. So popes, the antichrist, are proclaiming people who have no knowledge of gospel as saints for their hypocritical meekness. They are very meek, you know. And if you say something, they won't say anything, you know. And this is what I experienced a couple of days ago. Somebody from Grey Friar, there in Oxford, we have Grey Friars also. Somebody from another Grey Friar organization, he came to give a lecture. And man was very educated. He was in media industry, and then he became this Franciscan monk. So when I asked him, you know, in whose name John baptized men in water, and why the key to the kingdom of heaven was given to Peter, instead of asking me, he just said, "Oh." Then I asked him, "Shall I tell you?" He said, "No, no, leave it." He had no intention either to learn. So such people are antichrist. They are meek, they are humble. But people think, you know, "Oh, that man, very sweet spoken, this and that." Sweet spokens are sugar-coated tablets of falsehood that destroy. So people who go after these meek people and are satisfied because they speak sweetly, they go where that antichrist will go. Gospel is bitter. So unless you are capable of taking the bitter tablet, you cannot have gospel. Now, John the Baptist was an ideal rabbi, or the moral teacher, who was concerned with water in Adam. You know, in our body is mainly water. As our body is mostly water, that gives strength to people. Whereas the blood is the life-giving of God. If you have a wrestler, the main source of his strength is muscles. Muscles are water. So the blood is the life. So we can say that the moral laws of Adam are embodied in water, and gospel of God in blood. So we can say, you know, the moral laws are embodied in water. So that's why John the Baptist baptized them in water, whereas Christ Jesus baptized them at Eucharist in spirit. So as Adam is the natural man who obeys the laws of nature, tit for tat, or to every action there is equal and opposite reaction, so in spirit, we go the opposite way. That is, if someone hits you on one cheek, we present the other. Because if we hit him back, then we are hitting the temple of God, and one of us will get killed. So we will lose the temple of God. We want to win him over through humbleness, to presenting the other cheek. If he has conscience, then we have won him. We have taken over him. We have a good friendship then. So, in the other video, next one, I will explain the rest of the sermon.